Hey everybody, John Mark Comer here. I'm the pastor for Teaching and Vision at Bridgetown Church in Portland, Oregon, and the author of The Ruthless Elimination of Hurry. Merry Christmas to all of you. And on behalf of all the upcoming pastors and artists and all of our friends and family who are participating, welcome to Gather Christmas. Man, 2020 has been a very difficult year. I think we can all agree on that. And this is a very hard holiday season, as a lot of us wish we could be together, or we wish we could hug each other, or throw a bear hug around our grandmother or grandfather, or people that we love, or grandchildren, and people that we care about. And due to a global pandemic, we can't this year for a time. And so we just want to offer a little love and life and light to all of you wherever you are watching from by reading the Christmas story. The Christmas story is so pregnant, and that's the best word for it, with hope and with joy and with peace. And so as we read it over you, may it be not just sentiment, but may God by the Spirit just stir up a new kind of hope and joy and peace in you. Let's start by reading from Luke's Gospel, chapter 2. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. Notice that word, he went up to Jerusalem. That is a geographical statement, as it was at a high elevation, and a theological statement and a spiritual statement. He would make a spiritual journey to ascend to the presence and the peace of God. Let's have this Christmas be an ascent to the presence and the peace of God yet again.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day. They're old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men. I thought
you're here. It's been a long year, I've been holding out for this. Settled by the fire, thinking about how we ever made it this far. I woke up with a smile, gifts under the tree, and I'm feeling all the vibes. Lights are glistening, there's nothing left to do but just take it all in. And thank God it's Christmas, I've been away.
Hey everyone, it's Henry and Alex Seely here from The Belonging Co. in Nashville, Tennessee.
We're so excited to be celebrating Christmas with you. It's my favorite time of year as we celebrate the birth of our Savior.
We're going to continue reading from Luke chapter 2, starting at verse 6. It says, while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people."
I love this passage of scripture because most often when the angels of the Lord came to a person, the first thing that they would say is, "Do not be afraid." And at this moment in time, they were saying, you know what, this may look terrifying. You may be in a season this Christmas that looks terrifying, but I hope this scripture will remind you that the greatest joy came to earth to be our salvation. And that as long as Jesus Christ is in our heart and in our thoughts this Christmas, He is going to bring joy to your situation. He is the joy of this world. And we are so grateful that He would come and save us, humanity. And so you don't need to be terrified about anything this Christmas, but we get to celebrate the joy of the world coming to save our lives. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
We love you. Merry Christmas.
You know, it's one of my favorite songs, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Especially.
Same here. Yes. Yeah, especially singing it together.
Yes, yes.
Sing it, man.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Gone away is the bluebird.
Yes.
Here to stay is the new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman,
then pretend that he is Parson Brown.
He'll say, I am Mary, we'll say no man.
You can do the job when you're in town.
Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face unafraid the plans we have made, walking in a winter wonderland.
Grab your lover and do a little dance.
Listening in the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight,
walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird, here to stay is the new bird.
He sings a love song as we go along,
walking in a winter wonderland.
Meadow, we can build a snowman
and pretend that he's a circus clown.
We'll have lots of fun with Mr. Snowman until the other kids knock him down with his nose. Ain't it thrilling? Though your nose gets a chilling, we'll frolic and play the Eskimo way.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
Oh, walking in a winter wonderland.
Oh,
we're walking in a winter
Adore him, oh come let us Hey, what's up? I'm Michael Tate with the Newsboys, and yes, it is Christmas time again. So soon. So soon. 2020. What a year. However, one of my favorite passages, we all know this passage. We've all read it. Luke 2. Here we go. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes, lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." That's us. Thank the Lord. What more can you say? Christmas time, our Savior was born. Being a preacher's kid, I heard it all my life. I've heard the stories, read the verses. But golly, man, the older I get, the more I realize how, literally, how much of a gift that was to us. It is to us daily. And when I leave this planet, and I'm leaving the planet one day, I'm going to spend the rest of my existence with this Christ child, this Jesus, this God. You are too, if you're a believer. God bless you guys. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. And pray that COVID goes far away.
A palace worthy of our King. Too many walls to keep him in, but a mansion worthy of this Son was a stable that said, "Welcome." A journey on a starry night. The wisest ones follow the light, and they gather round the Holy One, who was born to love and lead us home. Yeah. Hark, the herald angels sing. Hear the sound and entering. Place reserved, just come. 'Cause Jesus eats with everyone. A child who is the King of Kings, who made a way of grace for sin. Our humble Savior gave it all, so we'd be seated with the Lord. Hark, the herald angels sing. Hear the sound and entering. There's a place reserved, just come. Jesus is with everyone. Hear the whisper of his heart. The goodness of our saving God. And it doesn't matter what we've done, 'cause Jesus is with everyone.
We're gonna sing, "We Gather at the Table."
We gather at the table of the Lord. Come one, come all, come as you are. We gather at the table of the Lord. To seek and you will find him. Come as you are. Oh, we gather at the table of the Lord. Come one, come all, come as you are. We gather at the the table of the Lord. To seek and you will find him. Come as you are. Oh, hear the whisper of his heart. The goodness of our saving God. And it doesn't matter what we've done, 'cause Jesus eats with everyone.
Your creation holds promise now. Savior once foretold, now laid here in
Hey everybody, Linda Randall here, and I'm so blessed and thankful to be a part of this Gather event. And I'd love to read a few scriptures to you found in Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 17. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. That's such a blessing. I love Christmas period, but the story of baby Jesus being born in the manger, it is such a humbling thing to know that the God of the universe would come as a little baby, not intimidating. He didn't feel threatening at all because he was this little innocent baby just because he wanted us to be able to relate to him in such a way. And it teaches me, it speaks mounds to me, that I should just live my life every day in the humility of this baby Jesus as we relate to one another, as I relate to my sisters and brothers in Christ and those that are not in Christ. So may the baby of the manger today remind you of the beauty of humility. And I'm so grateful that He's reminded me of that.
Am I the only one who is struggling here to have an attitude full of Christmas cheer after the crazy kind of year we've had? Maybe it's the stress of the crowded stores and trying to buy gifts that I can't afford. I know the season's so much more than that. So I'm choosing here and now to see what this day is all about to me. 'Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now, I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. On Christmas morning, I can see it all now in my memory. Waking up early, running to that tree, tearing that paper so that I could see my gifts. Then we would read Luke chapter 2 about Mary and Joseph and what they went through, and the infant king who would make things new again. And even though so many years have passed, in my heart I still hold on to that. 'Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now, I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. On Christmas morning, there's a child inside of all of us, and the gift we really need is love. 'Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now, I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. On Christmas morning, yeah. And when I think about it, even now, I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. Thank you.
Leanna Crawford, and welcome to my little home studio. I thought I'd start a little fire for us, make a little cozy in here. Let's continue reading one of my absolute favorite stories, the Christmas story from Luke 2. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. To be honest, I've never noticed that last part before, but Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. And how sweet that in the midst of all the excitement and celebration, Mary took a moment and recognized God's faithfulness in her life, the promise that she had been told just earlier, just a, you know, a few chapters ago or a chapter ago, that she was going to give birth to the Messiah. Now she's seeing a glimpse of that promise, and she's seeing God's faithfulness, and she's taking a moment to treasure that in her heart. And I just love that so much. She doesn't even get the full picture, but yet she's taking a moment to treasure it in her heart, to treasure up God's faithfulness and the sweet things that are happening around her. Whether Christmas is your favorite season ever, or Christmas is a really tough season and some hard things are connected with it, I hope you know and are reminded how much God loves you in this season, that he sent his son in very humble circumstances to be born in a barn, literally. And then years later, that same baby, that Messiah, would save us all when he died on the cross for our sins. Because he loves you, because he loves me, because he knew exactly where you would be in this moment, because he loves you so much. And I hope you know that and you are reminded. Thank you so much for hanging out with me during this part of the scripture reading. Merry Christmas.
I can almost see her standing at the end of the drive. Tears are running down her face as they say goodbye. Some call it the call of duty, some devotion to his country. That's not much to offer to a wife raising young daughters. Come December, he'll be coming home. Come December, she won't be alone. When the autumn leaves have fallen and the winter winds blow, it won't be long. 'Cause come December, he'll be coming home.
Deep within her heart, she knew these hard days would come. Because he always seemed to be the chosen one, so willing to give his all for everything he thought was right. Never one to run away from any fight. But come December, he'll be coming home. Come December, she will be alone. When the autumn leaves have fallen and the winter winds blow, it won't be long. 'Cause come December, he'll be coming home. Bullets fly, good
come December,
it won't be long.
He's finally made it home.
Born is the King.